G'day mates, Heartybbq here. We're going through all of the Grand Tournament's cards, card by card. I'm going to tell you my thoughts for Constructed and Arena. This time, we're looking at the Paladin card. So let's jump in with Argent Lance. Argent Lance looks like a super sweet card for the potential Joust build. And here's why. So, the Joust mechanic, revealing a minion from each deck. If yours costs more, you get an advantage. If you are not going to, if you're going to run with the Joust mechanic, you don't want to be playing low-cost minions. And if you're not playing low-cost minions, you need to have ways to deal with an early board. This is an ideal way. So a Lance enables you to clear off those early plays, all those fire imps and things that are going to be attacking you early. And it does have the upside that's going to go into your deck. So Argent Lance, for Constructed, if you are playing a Joust deck, so playing high-end minions with this Joust mechanic, you must play Argent Lance, and you probably want to. Just jam them in, and so you've got ways to interact with the board early that aren't early minions. If you're not playing the Joust mechanic, if you're not going to capitalize on this mechanic, then you've got better options for the early game in your early game minions. In Arena, this card is really good. Weapons are just, in general, quite good. And a 2-mana 2-2 is perfectly fine for Arena on its own, with the possibility for a little bit of upside. So I'm definitely happy running this in Arena. Competitive Spirit. When your turn starts, give your minions +1/+1. This is a very interesting card. So this is not going in a Joust deck. This is going to go into a very aggressive deck. There are a number of decks that want to play something like this. Now I wonder if it triggers only if you have minions on the board. I'm going to be curious to see how that actually plays out. My assumption is that it's going to trigger regardless of whether you have minions or not, but that will change its playability. Actually need to test that out to see. If it doesn't trigger when you have minions, you could play it on turn one, maybe wait until you have a turn where you can play a bunch of minions, maybe muster for battle on turn three. So a very interesting card, but if you are playing an aggressive deck, this is great value. You can stack in Revenge, Competitive Spirit are going to be ways that you can just have a few minions on the board and really go to town with value. So I like it quite a bit for aggressive decks in Paladin. I reckon this is definitely worth a shot. For Arena, it's a tougher sell in Arena. Again, whether it triggers when you have no minions is going to be quite a deal breaker in Arena. If this does trigger when you've got no minions, this is probably trash that you don't want. And then remember that if you're only getting +1/+1 on one minion, that is not worth one mana and a card. So you really need to have at least two minions on the board and probably more than that. So for Arena, this is probably not what you're looking for. Revenge is going to give you the value that you're looking for in a card, and Competitive Spirit is unlikely to in Arena. So I would steer clear of this in Arena. Edric the Pure. Now, this has really got people, some people love Edric, some people hate him, so it's really polarizing people in the opinions. Changing all enemy minions attack to one is an interesting ability. If your opponent, say, has just got one, well, you've really, really overpaid for a follow the rules. If you've got a whole board, so you have to have... This is what you'd have to get full value out of Edric. A big board, so maybe three or more minions, with high attack power, so higher than two attack power and three or more minions. So the chances of that coming up, it might not come up enough. In which case, Edric the Pure, 7 mana 3-7, is really terrible value. Let's consider the likely case, which is, let's say you're looking down a board of Patron Warriors. So you, so let's say your opponent's got 5 Patron Warriors on the board. You can change their attack power to 1. That could be okay, but you are just better off clearing the board, and Paladin has a number of ways to do that. So not really sold on Edric the Pure. I don't think that he's worth a slot in Constructed, probably. It is meta-dependent. There are some decks where you're really going to get some value, so maybe against something like druid, maybe, if they have a whole bunch of minions on the board. But even then, you really need to clear the board so that they don't force savage nature you. So I'd skip on Edric in constructed in arena. Arena is going to be fine. By turn 7, you and your opponent are just going to be matching big minions on the board, most likely. So it's probably going to be pretty good. You might have better options in the legendary slot if you do have a choice in arena, but Edric is going to be reasonable there. Enter the Colosseum. Destroy our minions except each player's highest attack minion. Interesting. For Enter the Colosseum to be good, you need... What do you need? You need a high power minion on the board, probably with high health as well. And it needs to be better than your opponent's. The really weird thing is you've already got a quality Consecrate at your disposal in Paladin. That costs 6 mana. It costs 2 cards as opposed to 1, but you do have ways to draw cards in Paladin. I don't see Enter the Colosseum actually being good in Constructed. Not a chance. Not a chance. In Arena? So you'd need to have the biggest minion on the board, and you need to have your opponent have lots of minions as well. It's so conditional. It's so conditional. Though I would rather not play it in Arena. You might be stuck with it, or you might choose to run it, and you will have situations where it will be good. What I'm just saying is the applications are fairly narrow, and if you do have the biggest minion on the board, but your opponent has a whole bunch of minions, you hopefully have better options than this. I don't know. I mean, you can get stuck in arena. Say you've got a Boulderfist Ogre and your opponent's got a whole bunch of small minions and they're just attacking face and you can't keep up. I have been in that situation, but it's narrow application, so I'd rather not play it in arena. Murloc Knight. Finally, another Murloc. So, Murloc Paladin. Will it be a thing? Probably not. Interesting for the Inspire mechanic. Most of the Inspire cards are pretty bad for stats, and they do require you to build up a few of these minions and then use your hero power to get full Inspire value. So if you are making an Inspire deck, it's very crucial that you curve out and you have Inspire minions at each cost on the mana curve. And Murloc Knight, it's got a reasonable Inspire effect. So it might be the 4 drop. So if you've got Inspire minions 3, 4, 5, and then maybe use your hero power. But it is quite underwhelming. I'm pretty underwhelmed by most of the Inspire mechanics. I'm going to say that this is not good in Constructed. That's just my feeling. In Arena, 4 mana 3, 4 is pretty bad stats. But yeah, if you play it on a board where, as long as it doesn't die straight away, you can get some value out of this, so it's probably okay, if not exciting, in Arena. Mysterious Challenger. Put one of each secret from your deck onto the battlefield. Interesting. In Constructed, a 6-mana 6/6 isn't the most exciting stats, but there are plenty of 6-mana 6/6s or even 6-mana 5/5s that see play, depending on their ability. So to leverage this, you need to have secrets, and you need to have different secrets. Unfortunately, the Paladin secrets are, in general, kind of sucky. So if you've got 3 different Paladin secrets, for example, you have to play some pretty sucky secrets to get in there. I think at one point in Constructed, this might be great, but this is not quite the opportunity for Paladin. All of the Paladin secrets do only cost 1. And most of them don't have a huge impact, so Mysterious Challenger is not great. It does have a lot of competition in Constructed at the 6th slot, so there's already plenty of legendaries and things that are just better than Mysterious Challenger, so it's not worth playing in Constructed. In Arena, 6-mana 6/6 is already reasonable stats. You do need to have at least 1 secret in your deck, but that's not too hard. If you've got 1 secret in your deck, then easy pickup. Mysterious Challenger is pretty good. Pretty good for Arena. Seal of Champions. Give a minion +3 attack and Divine Shield. Very interesting effect. this is actually not bad. So we already had a 1 mana add 3 attack to your minion, so quite similar to that. The aggressive decks do enjoy the cheap spell because they can use it and then they can use Divine Favor to reload their hand, so you don't have as much of Divine Favor value there, but the Divine Shield is pretty good. It does enable you to give 3 attack to a minion, get Divine Shield, and get value straight away. So get a card's worth of value immediately if you trade with a minion is pretty good. And if you are going face with it, you've got the extra Divine Shield protection. So I do like this. I like it a lot for constructed, for decks that do want to be aggressive. But I mean, in general, they already want to be playing cheap spells, and it might just cost too much for this effect. So, it's probably not going to see play in Constructed for that reason, but it might. It might. You do have the 3-mana legendaries that do want to be targeted, and this looks like a pretty great spell to target it with, for example. Worth a try. I think if only because of those 3-mana legendaries, obviously the one that gets Divine Shield when you target it, you're not getting as much value, but because of those, you want to be playing more spells like this. So I'm going to err on the side of this actually getting play constructed. Does look reasonable. In Arena, easy. So in Arena, all you have to do is make sure that you are killing off a minion immediately, and this is great. So take this, take it in multiples, it's fine. Make sure, so you've got, say, a 2-3, whatever your opponent plays, Seal of Champions your guy, and get value. Easy, easy, 2-for-1s. Done. Tuskar Jouster. What a sweet art. It's a walrus riding... Is that a tortoise? Let's say it's a tortoise. Sweet. 5-mana 5-5 is not exciting stats for Constructed. Let's look at the ability. Reveal a minion in each deck. If yours costs more, restore 7 health. Whoa. So... already in the life gain department, we have Antique Healing Bot, which is a 5-mana 3-3, so less stats, and it restores 8 health straight away. So, very similar. If you can reliably win the joust, holy heck, restoring 7 health and on a 5-5 for 5 is insane value. You're going to be wrecking and rolling aggro decks. So Tuskar Jouster is a shoo-in for Constructed if you want to be building a joust deck. The beauty of a card like this is Antique Healbot is not great against most control decks. It's just a 3-3. The life gain is pretty irrelevant. It's not very great. Tuskar Jouster, on the other hand, against an aggressive deck with a low curve, you're very likely to win the joust and get that 7 health, and this guy is great. Even against a control deck where you may not win the joust, the 7 health is not as important, but having a 5-mana 5-5 is still very good. So this guy is great for Constructed. For Arena, 5-mana 5-5 is fine already, and every now and then you'll restore some health, which may or may not be relevant, but it doesn't really matter because it's a 5-mana 5-5. So great for Constructed, great for Arena as well. Warhorse Trainer. So 3-mana 2-4 is bad stats? It's bad stats. Yep, your Silverhand Recruits have +1 attack. This is interesting, interesting, interesting. So the stats are completely made up. If you have one Silverhand Recruit on the table, because then you're effectively getting 3-mana 3-4. So that's not too hard. That's not a huge hoop to jump through. Muster for battle. Unfortunately, they both cost 3 mana, so if you're mustering for battle on 3 and then playing Warhorse Trainer on turn 4, that's a little bit awkward, but because it's so easy to get the +1 attack benefit there, this has got to be given a shot in Constructed. It's worth a try. It's worth a try. It might be good. Unfortunately, Muster for battle is just in an awkward spot because of Patron Warrior at the moment, and Warhorse Trainer certainly doesn't change that fact, but I think it's worth giving this a shot in Constructed. Maybe it's not a staple for Constructed, but it might be powerful enough. In Arena, again, you have to have one Silverhand Recruit to get your value. A 3-mana 2-4... you can forgive a 3-mana 2-4 a little more in Arena, so I think it's okay for Arena, sure. Not a problem. You're going to have probably less Silver Hand recruits in Arena, because just less muster for battles, obviously. But it's still okay. 3 mana 2/4 is okay. Just have one Silver Hand recruit on the board and you get your value. Seems fine to me. And that is all of the Paladin cards, mates. If you have a sweet brew for Paladin with the Grand Tournament cards, I want to know. Tweet at me at HuddyBBQ with your sweet list, and maybe I will choose it as soon as the set releases to give it a test run. So tweet those at me. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you check out my other review videos. So the neutrals sorted by rarity, including legendary, as well as all of the other class cards as well for your viewing pleasure. But until next time, thanks for watching.